Welcome to Notes on Nature TV. I'm Jamie, and in this episode, we're going to be looking at the world of warblers. So sit back and enjoy our beginner's guide. Here are 10 of the warblers that you might see or hear in the UK. Let's start with two very similar warblers, which are found pretty much all over the UK in summer. Now, the first one is the chiffchaff. It's really easy to identify by song, and we'll come to that in a minute, but let's take a look at what a chiffchaff looks like. And you'll see this bird flitting around in the canopies of trees, sometimes coming down a bit lower, picking insects off the leaves and twigs. Now, as you can see here, this is a small bird. It's about the size of a blue tit, and it will pump its tail up and down while it's moving around the tree, flicking that tail. There's a dark line through the eye and a pale stripe just above it. Now the call, as I mentioned before, really, really easy to identify. It's a high-pitched way of saying its name, really. Chiff-chaff, chiff-chaff, chiff-chaff. Have a listen to this. So that's the chiff-chaff, one of the earliest summer migrants to arrive in the country in spring. Now let's compare it with the willow warbler, which is another lovely little bird. Both of these are around the size of a blue tit. So the blue tits you perhaps are more familiar with in your garden, you're looking for something around that size, up in the canopies of the trees, flitting around, as I say. Now the difference between the willow warbler and the chiffchaff is hard to tell, especially when there are leaves on the trees, but let's take a look, let's compare the two. So on the left, you've got the chiffchaff, and on the right, you've got the willow warbler. Take a look at the legs on the chiffchaff, much darker, almost black legs. Whereas on the willow warbler, you've got quite pale, almost orangey legs. The chiffchaff has a more drab, browny look than the willow warbler. The willow warbler is more yellow, more fresh looking, and there's more white underneath. And the stripe over the eye, I think, is a little bit brighter. The song is very different too. Now, have a listen to this. This is beautiful. It's a tinkling, cascading series of notes. There's more to it than the chiffchaff's delightful, but rather simple song. It's a little bit more complex, isn't it? It's like a waterfall of notes, a cascade of notes going downwards. Now, warblers sing all the time as they arrive in the UK, even if they just stop for rest while they're on their way to their patch. So do listen up for these two. Now, there's a third warbler, which was once thought, along with the chiffchaff and the willow warbler, to all be one type of bird, the willow wren. And back in the 1780s, the Reverend Gilbert White, who was a famous naturalist, worked out that there were three different birds by listening to their songs. The wood warbler, you can see here, it's much brighter in colour than the first two birds. It's got a vivid green that matches the fresh beech leaves they'll be feeding among in the tree canopy. And listen to this song. It sounds to me like a coin spinning. Unlike the chiffchaff and the willow warbler, the wood warbler is going to be much harder for you to see. And that's partly because they're in decline here. They've disappeared from over half of the places they used to be found, and well over half of the population has vanished over the last few decades. So they're on the UK Red List, and we're trying to investigate what's going on. You can still see and hear wood warblers at some of our nature reserves like Lake Vyrnwy, Loch Lomond, Wood of Cree, and Innes here. So those are three very similar warblers. Now let's take a look at some more. There's the garden warbler, which despite its name is not often seen in gardens. It prefers to be in river valleys, in wet habitat. And have a think about the colours. We've looked at a gradient of bright-ness, haven't we? The chiffchaff fairly dull, The willow warbler a little brighter, the wood warbler brighter still, and we've gone back down the scale now to a rather a drab looking bird. The Latin name for the golden warbler is actually Sylvia Borin. Borin could be said to relate to the colours, but actually the song is one of the most beautiful. This is a bird that will skulk in the bushes, so you won't get a great view of it usually, but it has got a big black eye, a shorter beak than some of the other warblers, and a bit of a grey collar you can see there just by the head. And have a listen to this song. Absolutely glorious. And there's another warbler with a very similar song, which is the black cap. Black cap's pretty easy to identify because it's the only warbler that actually has, as the name suggests, a black patch of plumage on top of its head. The male has a black cap, the female has a chocolate brown cap. And the song, I think, nearly always has a bit of a scratchy element to it, whereas the garden warbler is more fluty and more melodic. But the black cap song is beautiful, and it sounds to me like a more high-pitched version of the more familiar blackbird song. Because of its beautiful song, it's also known as the Northern Nightingale. Take a listen. And that's the wonderful black cap. Now, a lot of these warblers, though they won't regularly pop into our gardens, you might get black cap, chiffchaff, especially some of the ones that overwinter here, which come from Eastern Europe. The ones we're talking about now will have flown up from Africa and Southern Europe for the summer. But they tend not to be garden birds, overall warblers. You'll see them in scrubland, in woods, in wetlands, in wet woodlands. So think about things like reed beds and gorse bushes and willow, hence the willow warbler. Now, there are two that you'll regularly find in marshland or around lakes, and their names kind of give away where they like to live. So the first one is the reed warbler. Now, take a look at the reed warbler here. This is a brownish bird, a sort of reddish brown on the top and a pale underside. And as the name suggests, you'll find this bird in and among the reeds. And there's a very similar sedge warbler, which you'll find in same kind of habitat, really, same kind of place. And this will go into the reeds, it will go into the vegetation around the reeds, the hedges and the shrubs. It's got slightly more patterned feathers than the reed warbler. And look at that eye stripe, it's much more striking. Now let's compare the two songs. The reed warbler is said to have a bit more rhythm. It's a bit more melodic. Whereas the sedge warbler's song is up and down, it's all over the place. It mimics as well, it will sample other birds' songs, so you might recognise a few snippets of songs of other birds in there. Sedge warblers will also sing in flight, they'll pop up out of the vegetation, bursting up into the air singing. Let's hear those two songs again. The reed warbler. And the sedge warbler. Now there's another warbler that you'll find around wetland areas, and that's the Chetty's warbler. Really, really difficult to see this bird. I've only ever had a good view of one once at our Lake and Heath Fen Nature Reserve. That's a place that used to be carrot fields, but now it's this amazing mosaic of wetland habitats with reed beds and scrub and a few trees and water, and the warblers absolutely love it. But back to the Chetty's. How do you identify one? Well, it's a fairly large warbler. It's got a long tail, which the bird will flick up and down. The back and the wings of the Chetty's warbler are a warm reddish brown colour, and the side of the head and the breast are more grey. It's actually the only bird that we have here that has 10 tail feathers. Most of us have 12, not that you're ever likely to see it in that much detail. It's also the only bird we have here that lays really red eggs. It's the song that will give away the Chetty's warbler. It's a real burst of sudden sound from the reed bed or the depths of the vegetation. There's nothing else quite like that. Have a listen again. That's the Chetty's warbler. Now, the final two warblers we're going to look at are the white throat and the lesser white throat. So how do you tell them apart? First of all, the white throat. Open scrub, coastal areas and wetland are all home to this bird. It's similar to a great tit in size. It's got pale legs, bright reddish brown wings, and if you can see it when it's singing, it's probably a white throat. Like the sedge warbler, it will rise up in the air for a few metres whilst doing a flight song. A very distinctive looking bird with that white throat and a grey cap. The female doesn't have the grey cap, but it does have the white throat. Whereas the lesser white throat has much more contrast in its colour. The head is darker, the throat is whiter. It has dark legs, whereas the white throat has pale legs. And the song is very different. Let's listen to the two songs. The first is the white throat, which will sing fairly out in the open. As I say, you'll see it. And here's the lesser white throat singing. This will be performed from hidden away, deep in thick, dense, impenetrable vegetation. So there are some warblers to look out for and listen out for this spring. If you've enjoyed this video, please do like it and subscribe to RSPB videos on YouTube. Thank you for watching.